Welcome to Penn Basketball Weekly, presented by PNC with head coach Steve Donahue. Joe Torti with you. Coach, thanks for joining us today.
It's great to be here, Joe.
It's been a busy November for you already. Three games in the books. You got 9 games in total this month. What's it been like for you to start the season?
Well, when we saw the schedule that we were going to play so many games in a short period of time, you're actually excited for it because I thought it was a great chance to really figure out where you're at, play those extra games in that exemption tournament. But now when you start hitting the, you go on the road, you lose a tough one, you play a double overtime game at home. And fortunately, last night we came out. And I think it's been great for all of our younger guys. And even, we have a nucleus that's trying to gel. Antonio Woods, we mentioned the freshmen, those type of situations as well.
Obviously, playing a game just about every other night, I know teaching is a huge part of what you do as a coach. Were there advantages, disadvantages to not being able to put as much time in between games looking at the last one?
Well, listen, when you play a game and you watch it, you want to go back and teach and get better at all those things. You got to fight that urge. We really haven't even dissected Fairfield or LaSalle. That would be our typical. I just thought it would be counterproductive to go back at this point. We talked about certain things, what we can do better, and then prepare for the next opponent.
There's been a big difference, though, either way, from the Fairfield game versus the two following games. You set a program record for 3-point attempts against Fairfield. It's really been limited to many fewer attempts than that in the next two games. Is that by design? How does that work out?
And a lot of it is what we teach and how we play. So we like to get a layup or a dunk or get fouled doing it. That's always the first objective. Decision making is a huge part of what we talk about a lot. So when you drive the ball to the rim, we like to call it the 95% rule. If you're not 95% certain that you can score or get fouled, then we have other things that we look for, and one of them is a standstill three. And Fairfield forced us to do that. There may have been a couple, but we could have made 20 of them. That being said, when you're not hitting them, you got to adjust as well and continue to probe. I don't think we did a very good job of that. That was the learning curve. So LaSalle, another one, and then Navy last night, we were concerned that they were going to play the matchup the whole time. They didn't, but I thought ball movement, shot selection, understanding how we're going to win on offense was much better.
Looking big picture, this is your third year with the team. First year's team looked dramatically different from last year's team, and then this year's team. What's the identity in relation to the previous two?
I think that's a great way of putting it, because we talk about identity and what is our identity. Identity is not like you can make it up and put it on the back of your shirt and that's it. Your identity's earned, and it's very organic in terms of what you do to an opponent. I thought last night was a sign of what our identity can be. I think we can be really physical and tough defensively. Just really, I think we don't give much away. We guard the 3-point line, we limit you to one, and we still create turnovers. The other part of that is I think we got to understand that we can be really good with the basketball. For the most part, we've taken care of it. So on one end, we're tough, we limit you to one, defending hard, and on this end, really moving the ball, not giving away possessions, and making smart decisions. If we can continually do those things, then I think we're going to be, your identity will come. And that's what we all work for.
If somebody was looking at the box score from the Navy game, they'd say, wow, Navy really didn't shoot well. But watching the game, you guys had a ton to do with that. So is that something that you hope to build on, considering that's a team that beat Pittsburgh and was in it with Miami in the first half?
No doubt. I think last year we set the tone with our defense. We were arguably the second best team in our league. We were top 100. Everyone essentially coming back was the exception of Matt. Bigger, stronger with the addition of Antonio Woods. I think we can be an elite defensive team. The numbers now after 3 games are 3 games I've never seen. We've given up 9 threes. Is that right? I'm trying to think now. 2.7 per game. 8 threes in 3 games. Teams are shooting 16%. And on the same sense, we're turning people over at double their assist rate. That's unheard of, and the overall shooting percentage is 40. And we don't foul. Those are numbers that you win championships on. That's how we're going to continue to grow, and I've been really pleased with our defense.
Coming into the season, all the eyes were on A.J. Broder, obviously stormed onto the scene last year. So did Ryan Bentley towards the end of it. But it's really been a lot of the supporting members of your team that have kind of taken the leading role through the first three games. How much of it is that these guys have taken steps forward versus all of the attention being on these guys and them being at the top of the game plan?
I think it's a couple things. In particular, Fairfield, he had 27 against last year. A lot of the reason for all those 39 shots was they've really just collapsed. LaSalle at 35, They weren't going to let that happen again. Last night, I thought you saw what other guys can do. Caleb Wood, Darnell Foreman, Max is another guy. That's the other part of this. Playing Max and AJ a lot more together, it's a little different position for AJ. Not necessarily maybe benefiting him right now, but it will. And most importantly, I think it's benefiting our team in a lot of ways if we can play those two together. I think that's why you see maybe less big games from AJ, but he still does so many different things. I thought he did an incredible job on BJ Johnson guarding him. I thought last night he was great as well, defensively.
You mentioned Antonio Woods as well. What's his return meant to the team?
Well, I think we're still trying to figure that out. And I think we're going to be a team because of our depth and different tools that we have, is that there's nights that I think, like LaSalle, that I can put two really strong athletic guards in Darnell and Antonio and really shut down them. Games like Navy, that we probably need to space the floor, bring in the Caleb Wood to go with one of those two guys, play Jackson Donahue. I think Antonio showed, I think he's our best passer. I think he has the best feel for the game. Getting the rust off now, getting used to playing, trying to be more consistent in shooting. He guards typically anybody 1 through 4 because of his strength and his quickness and his toughness. It's a great asset to have.
And finally, looking ahead here, you've got a game against Penn State Brandywine coming up on Saturday. What kind of challenges does that present for you, playing a team that's not necessarily in your classification?
Yeah, I think it is a challenge because I played Division III. It's going to be a thrill for them to play in this building. I think our guys respect that and understand it. I think you got to really judge it, effort, talk about some really good qualitative things. How good do we move the ball? How many times did we reverse it? Did we really help the helper? Like some really things besides the score, which you really make sure you take care of. But if you really put the onus on those things and you're coaching that during the game and requiring guys to do that, I think you can almost get lost in those details rather than what may the score be or what the competition is.
And then right after that, you hop on a plane to go down to Florida for a tournament. What's that going to be like early on in the season?
It's awesome. You know, you play a real in-season tournament, 3 games in 3 days, really good competition, but also a competition I think we can compete with. In particular, after this little run, you figure out who we are. We're a much better basketball team, in my mind, now than we were last Friday, just because of all the things that occurred, and understand how we're going to win. And that's a tournament that gives you a chance to play on a neutral site against real good teams and see what happens.
Well, Coach, we'll find out what happens. We'll be watching, paying attention, and we'll talk to you next week.
Great. Thanks, Joe.
This is Head Coach Steve Donahue and Joe Torti on Penn Basketball Weekly, presented by PNC.